So, a problem is that every time a cool movie is invented, Spain comes along and ruins it with one of their titles. And it angers me so much. We turned it into a game show. What?
Oh my god! Is it B?
Are you sure about that?
Might as well be.
That is incorrect. Congratulations, Cole. You are the winner of the first ever Lost in Translation.
Congratulations on winning. If Emilio hadn't done that, I would have won. Just know, people, I am smarter in that regard.
What's up, homies? Welcome back to Lost in Translation 2021, the best game show ever. We brought back everybody's favorite contestants. We've got the guy from the Trash Talk podcast.
Hello, everybody. Hello, it's me, Ryan, aka The Boss.
It is mathematically impossible for Cole to catch up to Ryan at this point. So the next question is worth 1 bajillion points. For C, this person didn't exist. For 1 bajillion points.
Hey.
That is
game show, you asshole.
Welcome back to Lost in Translation. I'm your host, Emilio. Let's meet this year's contestants. In the right corner, we have a new challenger.
That'll be me. I'm Nucopy Demon.
And as always, our constant runner-up, Ryan Bittner. Welcome back, Ryan.
Yeah, hello, everybody. Welcome back. It's me, Ryan, or The Boss, for those of you who know me. The true winner of previous years, but this year, Emilio won't be able to fake his way out of this one.
Ryan, if you get this one correct, you get 5 points, and you win the game.
Yes.
What is A Bug's Life called in Germany? Is it A, The Big Crawl, B, Bugs, or C, Big Bugs and Small Bugs?
Is it A?
Congratulations, Ryan. You just won Lost in Translation.
Yes!
Can you guys feel that?
But we both know the
what?
Truth. You won't be the true champion until you beat me.
Oh my god, no! It's my arch nemesis. Cole, what are you doing here?
Kick your ass, of course.
The last challenge, Ryan, is to beat Cole. I'm going to give you translations of the character Wednesday from the show. And you have to tell me which one is the fake one.
I'm going with B.
I go for G. Number G.
Don't you do this, Amelia. Don't you do this.
I have to sadly announce that Jesse is a true winner.
Oh, yeah!
Let's go!
Oh, Jesse lost!
Hey, Ryan. We like it.
Not a huge surprise, but clearly one of the great comebacks since Burt Reynolds' hairline. It came in a two-word statement, which is now just begging to have a Nike campaign built around it. Quote, unquote, I'm back. That's all.
Ryan.
On Saturday, that was really all
Ryan
did to say as his 17-month retirement came to an end.
I'm happy that he's back. I think he's back because he was missing competition, and he's ready to go again. But I don't think, in my mind, I don't favor them to win it.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Lost in Translation, the show where we check out how they change the titles of our favorite movies, characters, and other random shenanigans that has to do with other languages. I'm your host, Emilio, and as always, I'm here with everybody's favorite contestants, Ryan and Cole.
You know, it's like you just went to college, you know, studying, you know, being an adult, and coming back to your high school and seeing, like, God, this is all fucking shit.
Well, everyone, first of all, hello. Welcome back to another episode of Lost in Translation. I am back once again to take the crown. And after another year of training in the mountains and killing Jesse so there was one less contestant to worry about, I am back here to finally reclaim my crown. Cole, we're going down.
Round one is your standard Lost in Translation round, where we have a question three options. If you get the question right, it's 1 point. If you get the question wrong, it goes to the next person and they can answer it. If they get it right, it's 2 points. If they get it wrong, the person that originally got the question wrong gets 3 automatic points. What's special about this round is that each round you'll get to hear the synopsis for the TV show or movie. Cole, since you are the reigning world champion, you get to decide, do you go first or do you let Ryan go first?
I believe that, you know, we should give other people chances, you know, like, you know, I consider myself as a, like an activist, you know, so I believe that, you know, that we should give Ryan a chance.
Formula One, Drive to Survive in France. Is it called A, Formula One, the series, Formula One, Pilots of Their Destiny, or Formula One, Drama on the Grid?
I am going to go with, in the spirit of Jesse, rest his soul, I'm going to go with number B.
That is correct, Ryan. You get 1 point. Okay, Cole. Mm-hmm. Poltergeist in Mexico. Is it called A, Diabolical Games, B, Evil Games, or C, Macabre Games?
Oh, it's clearly A, Diabolical Games.
That is correct. Cole gets 1 point. Ryan, The Hangover in Mexico. What happened yesterday? What happened last night? Or, ah, my head hurts.
Yes, that last one is definitely a definition of a hangover. I'm going to go with B.
That is incorrect.
Damn it.
What happened yesterday?
That is correct. Cole gets 2 points.
Let's go!
Cole, the movie We Are the Millers in Mexico. Is it called A, Family Road Trip, B, Meet the Millers, or C, Who the Fuck Are the Millers?
B.
That is incorrect.
Fuck.
I'm gonna go with A.
That is incorrect. Cole gets 3 points. The title of the movie is Who the Fuck Are the Millers? What is the TV show Small Egg Eyes called in the United States? A, Comedy is Blind, B, Nothing to See Here, or C, Did Not Change It?
I will take a synopsis for this one because I've never heard of this show.
Alexis, a young blind man who dreams of being a successful comedian, moves to the largest city in the world accompanied by his best friend and manager, Charlie, who has cerebral palsy. What could go wrong?
I'm going to take a stab at it again and say B.
That is correct. B, Nothing to See Here. So we have a returning favorite for round two. We brought back the wheel, everybody. So this is the wheel of characters. In this wheel, there are a bunch of characters with their translated names. You have to guess which character are they talking about in English. You also have the right to ask from which show each character is, but you only get to ask that once. So are you guys ready? So Ryan, since you're losing, you spin the wheel first, so you let me know when I stop spinning this wheel. Okay, Bellota, which translates to acorn.
Well, acorn doesn't give me a lot to work off of, so I'll give it a shot.
Okay, this character is from the Powerpuff Girls.
I never watched that show much growing up. Acorn. Is it Bubbles?
That is incorrect, Ryan. It's actually Buttercup. Bombón, which means marshmallow in Spanish.
What show is this guy from?
Okay, it's also from the Powerpuff Girls.
What the fuck would we call marshmallow? Oh, Bubbles.
That is incorrect. It's actually...
What the fuck?
Blossom.
That is so fucking stupid. This...
Thaddeus Quentin Tentacle from Germany.
I want to say, before I attempt to answer this, as a former college student, I want to use all of the knowledge that I've accumulated over the years to make an extremely educated guess using my academic psyche and to really figure out who this character is. So that being said, with the information that Emilio has supplied me, I'm going to confidently put my foot down and say Squidward Tentacles from SpongeBob.
That is correct, Ryan. You get 1 point.
He called it the power of college education.
Perna Longa. This is the name of this character in Brazil. And in Portuguese, it means long legs.
Cole, you should be used to this as a college student, always on edge.
I don't fucking know any cartoon character, man. When I was a kid, you know, I was like a very mature kid, you know. I only watch shows for men. I was watching Breaking Bad when I was 6 years old. I feel like if anyways, let's give it to fucking Bugs Bunny or some shit.
That is correct. It's Bugs Bunny. Blame the Brazilians. What do you want me to do? Lindinha in Brazil, which means cute one.
I swear if this is Powerpuff Girls kid Emilio.
Joe Biden.
Is it Bubbles?
That is correct. It is Bubbles. Carlo Tentacul in France.
Who the fuck? I don't know. I don't know who the fuck. Carlo. Who the fuck?
Use your college abilities.
I want to have a class called Cartoon 101, man. I'm studying film, you know. Films for big boys, you know, not for little children. Tentacles. So what cartoon character has tentacles? Squidward, right?
That is correct. Gustavo.
What the hell? What cartoon character would have a name like it? Okay, so it's not Powerpuff Girls. I can safely eliminate that one.
I'll give you a hint, Ryan, for this one.
This one isn't just a cartoon character. There's also, I guess, puppets of it. It's more commonly known for that.
Crap.
It's clearly Gustavo Fring from Breaking Bad.
There were... I'm going to take a stab at it, because I can't really think of any other iconic character that fits that description. Is it Kermit the Frog from The Muppets?
That is correct. 1.4 Ryan.
Yes. Thank you, Kermit, for never letting me down. You have a great Christmas special, by the way.
Who is Lobezno?
If you don't know me, I love comic books. It's my favorite thing. So, all my college money is going to cheap-ass food, my tuition, my commute to school, then back home, and comic books. Is this still cartoons, or is this superheroes? Or comic books?
It is a superhero, yes.
Oh, okay, never mind, we win, okay. Alright, so this, I'm just using, honestly, I don't know what the answer is, but I'm gonna use this time to talk about the comics I have, and then just give a weak-ass answer. Anyways, I recently got Ultimate Universe, which is the...
80 minutes later.
So what's your final answer?
Wolverine, I guess. It's the one thing that sounds closer.
That is correct. It is Wolverine. This is the hardest one.
Oh, come on.
Ze Colmeia.
No translation? Nothing?
No, that's his name in Brazil. If you get this one, I'll give you 10 points automatically.
10 points? Ooh, so there's a lot on the line with this one, too. Shit.
Any
details that are present within this guess? Any at all?
Yogi Bear.
I'm going to take a stab in the dark here from a random cartoon character. Is it Yogi Bear?
It is Yogi Bear. Ryan, you get 10 points. Okay, Cole. The last character on the wheel is Gaguinho from Brazil. Apparently, it means the one who stutters in Brazilian slang.
The one who's... Man, like, I really don't know, but I also don't want Ryan to win, finally.
Do I have to give away another 10 points for you guys to figure it out?
Oh, yeah. I think it would only be fair, you know?
It seems you got 5 points, but that's as far as I'm going with it.
The only one I know... That's a wrap! It's the Porky the Pig, you know, from Looney Tunes?
That is correct! It is Porky! That's 5 points for Cole. last round. We have here 6 different translations for the movie Up in different languages, and you have to match from which country that translation comes from. You have 5 minutes, and we'll share our results at the end. Best of luck.
Man, Google's not helping me out at all here.
Why are you on Google?
Time's up. Time's up. Everybody hands up. All right. Since Cole is down by 1 point, Cole, will you read us your answers first?
To the skies, Ukraine. Onward and upward, China. What is it called? Mr. Carl's Flying House, France. Miracles, Arabic. Above, I don't know how to pronounce this fucking country. Czechia, whatever the fuck. Sorry, I apologize, Czechia. Up there, Japan.
Cole, you got 0 correct. Ryan, you are finally the winner of Lost in Translation. Congratulations.
Thank goodness, yes. Yes.
Finally, I win. After 4 years of this fucking show, I have finally won Lost in Translation. Oh my gosh. I expected this to feel better, but I'm still very happy.
Time Magazine's Person of the Year has just been revealed, and that person is, drumroll please,
What a great accomplishment.
Son, hey, wake up.
What?
You're sleep talking again.
But no, I won a game show. I won Lost in Translation. Finally, after all this time, I finally won.
I don't know what you're talking about, but whatever it is, you're just dreaming. None of what you're talking about ever happened.
Wait, what? You mean it was all a dream?
No! Damn it!
Hello, everybody. I just finished editing this episode of Lost in Translation, the last episode of Lost in Translation. I'm doing it because I don't have kind of any new ideas, and I do think it's time to revamp what I do at the end of the year on this channel. And also, I wanted to come on here at the end of the video to give a bit of an update on me. You know, I only posted, counting this one, 3 videos this year. And as you've seen, there's been a few changes. I moved. That was kind of one of the main things that delayed a bit how I was able to put out videos. Also,
work and school, and I had an incident with my hard drive. Basically, my hard drive had like an internal failure, and so I lost a ton of files. I did have a video that was already ready to post, but I lost a bunch of files from another video that I was also working on, so now I have to restart on that video. I will be posting that first video that I had, and then continue working on the new video that I already had filmed, but I lost. But yeah, it's been a crazy year for me personally. I wish I would have had more time to share it here on YouTube. Next year, I finish college, I get my degree. Hopefully, I will have more time to post on this YouTube channel and just go back to the way it was. It'll be awesome. This channel is turning 10 years old next year. I have no idea what I'm gonna do. I just wanted to thank you guys for being patient. Hopefully we get to actually hang out in 2024. Not like 2023. But yeah. See you later. Happy New Year. Goodbye to Lost in Translations.